This tutorial will show how to install FreePascal Compiler version 3 and Lazarus IDE version 1.6 on Mac 10. FreePascal is an easy programming language to learn. It works on Windows, Mac, and Linux. It is a free download at lazarus-ide.org, and there are free tutorials at schoolfreeware.com and on SchoolFreeware's channel. This tutorial will use the FreePascal Compiler version 3, the Lazarus IDE version 1.6, and Mac OS 10.11.4 El Capitan. Before we can install Lazarus and the FreePascal compiler, we will need to download and install Xcode. Xcode is a free download at the App Store. Since this computer already has Xcode installed, I will just go ahead and go straight to the Xcode command line tools, which will need to be installed via the terminal. The terminal can be found within the hard drive, applications, utilities, and then terminal. To install the command line tools, put xcode -select --install within the terminal and press return. Click on install and agree. Once the software is installed, click done. And then we need to go to lazarus-ide.org and download the three DMGs, the FreePascal compiler, the FreePascal compiler sources, and the Lazarus IDE. Once they are downloaded, first install the FreePascal compiler. Followed by the FreePascal compiler sources. And then the Lazarus IDE. If we were to run the Lazarus IDE at this time, we would get an error because the GNU debugger cannot be found. So we will have to install the GDB at this time. To install the GDB, within terminal, put in this command. The command will also be on the School Freeware website and within the video's description. If it asks for a password, please enter in your computer's password. Next, we'll run brew install GDB. Okay, within Keychain Access, what we have to do is make a certificate for the GDB. We'll find the Keychain Access within Applications, Utilities. With Keychain active, we'll go to the menu, Keychain Access, Certificate Assistant, and then create a certificate. The name will be GDB-CERT. The identity type will be self-signed root, and the certificate type will be code signing. We will check Let Me Override Defaults and then click on Continue. Next, we should increase the period from 365, try about 7,000 days so we don't have to worry about it until the year 2035. We'll then click on Continue, Continue again, Continue, 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 and then here within specify location for the certificate, we want to go to System. If we have a problem with creating the keychain in System, then create the keychain in Login, and then later on export it to the system. I'll now click on Create since the keychain is set to System, and we're done. Okay, moving on, we'll have to go find the certificate. I'll go into System, and then Certificates, and there's our GDP cert. I'll right mouse click and get info. Under Trust, I'll go to Code Signing. And click on Always Trust. I'll then close down Keychain Access, and I'll have to restart the computer. Okay, now that the computer is restarted, we'll go ahead and put the following line into the terminal. And we are now ready to run Lazarus. Okay, once within Lazarus, we'll go to Tools, and we'll configure Build Lazarus. The LCL will be Carbon, the target OS will be Darwin, and the target CPU at this time will be i386. I'll go ahead and build. This may take a while, so please be patient. Once Lazarus is done, we'll simply quit Lazarus and open Lazarus back up. I'll put in a button and a label, and we'll just try a simple Hello World program. I'll go ahead and run. And I'll go ahead and stop.